carries. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I don't serve on the Insurance and Financial Services Committee along with most of our members here, so I'd like to ask a question for the chair.
Representative may pose a question.
Thank you. The representative from Newcastle previously made the point that this bill had been debated in previous sessions and claimed that this is more moderate than previous proposals. The word compromise was used to describe the bill and the process that brought us here today. So I ask the majority, someone from the majority of the committee to explain what compromises were made to the substance of the bill in the committee process to bring it here to help us support how we should make our votes.
Questions have been posed through the chair to anyone who may choose to answer. Chair recognizes the representative from Hallowell, Representative Tree.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. In response to that question from the good representative from Lewiston, Representative Carey, we only had one work session on this bill. It was on Friday of this past Friday. The hearing was on Wednesday on a 3.5-page bill. We were handed a 25-page amendment at that time. We got to the work session. There was a different bill with changes in it. I think there may have been compromise that went on amongst the people that wrote that amendment, but it did not involve any of the minority members of the committee. At that work session, we got through about 10 or 11 bills, most of which we killed because they were related subject matter. It was the interest of the sponsor of this bill to include a lot of that subject matter in his bill. So we all went along with that. Then it was time to talk about the bill, and the Senate chair asked for us to recess for 2.5 hours. I objected. It was only 10:30 in the morning. I didn't understand why we were recessing when the day was ahead of us and we had a lot to do, including walking through the bill that we had just been handed, which is 29 pages long, and understand what was in it. We never did walk through that bill on that Friday. We walked through a 3-page pink sheet that summarized some of the provisions, and we weren't allowed to ask questions on that. I asked a series of questions, which I subsequently tried to put into written form, and that's what you see on the orange letter, and that Representative from Cuxton, Representative Shane, mentioned his question, his general question to the floor. The Bureau of Insurance was not in attendance at the one work session. There was nobody there from the Bureau of Insurance, and I don't even think of the department, I'm not sure. We did have testimony on the bill from the department. It involved pretty much like one paragraph that said, we think that health reform is really important. We're generally in favor of things that make health insurance less expensive. And the commissioner actually said, please don't ask me any technical questions about this bill because I'm not the person who does the answers. If you read the order sheet, you will see that there was a lot of specific questions that were asked about how this would affect the rates of different people in Maine. Questions about the geographic changes, many of those things. You did not get answers to any of those questions. We asked to table the bill until we could get some answers to those questions so that we could understand what it was we were going on, so that we could know whether or not there was a different plan that we might want to compromise on. We were told very clearly the intention was to vote it that day, and we could ask as many questions as we wanted, but nobody was there to answer them. Only the committee analysts who did the best you could. So we were seeking to vote. The chairs were there specifically asked by the representative from Waterloo, Representative Beck, if they would be willing to take out certain provisions of the bill that seem to be the least well thought out and cause the most concern to those of us in the minority. And the good representative from Waterloo was told flat out, absolutely not. We had a meeting of the chairs and leads, where I made the discussion with my colleague from the other body, both the chair and the senator from Portland, Senator Brannigan. We commented, we hadn't actually had a time to read the bill that would be asked to vote on. And I was then told by the Senate Chair that he had not read the bill either, but that I should not be concerned because some very smart people wrote it. I'm not joking. We went back into the committee. There were some other side meetings that went on between members of our committee and the lobby, the majority members of the committee and the lobby, and the chairs. We proceeded to a vote. The boss made statements about our concern. And then we had the vote. And after the vote, the representative from Newcastle said that we shouldn't really be concerned about it, and the fact that we had then had a bunch of papers dumped on the desk that were 2 inches tall, that purported to try to answer to some of the questions we had, that basically were reports from previous years from other states. And obviously we couldn't read them in the time available anyway, because they were relevant, or to know if they were relevant. We were told by that good representative that we had the weekend to read through that material. Of course, the fact that it was after the vote was sort of a problem. We then came to this Wednesday. When was that? Oh, that was yesterday. Yesterday, we went in for a final language review. And because I try to adhere to the rules of the House, I'm not going to wait around what was handed to us. But it's a 45-page document that consists of handwritten notes in the margin, cross-outs on pretty much every page, underlining some things that were already underlined, underlining some things that weren't underlined. We did get a chance to walk through that. It was supposed to be a final language review. I understand the Speaker has already ruled that the joint rules were complied with, even though this amendment was substantially different. It dramatically changed a high-risk goal to a reinsurance plan. It made it better. That's good. I'm glad that our questions must have prompted some concern on the part of those pushing this amendment to go back to the drawing boards on at least one piece of it. But that's not compromise. That's not how you compromise and come up with a good plan. So to answer your question, and to answer the question that the representative requested, Representative Shane, you know, we did get some information from the Bureau of Insurance. Most of it was emailed to us on Tuesday night. Well, emailed to some of us. And that information was actually out of date on Wednesday because one of the questions related to what's consistent with federal law and what isn't. And on Wednesday, we were told, well, some things that weren't consistent now are, but we can't really tell you which ones or how much they are.